Hi guys, I'm Sareka Unique. I'm the founder of Black Girls Illustrate. Black Girls Illustrate is a platform used to amplify the voices of Black women artists and illustrators. I'm also an artist, illustrator, and surface pattern designer. I love creating bright and bold patterns and artwork. And today I am going to show you guys how to create your own seamless repeating pattern using Procreate. So go ahead, grab your iPad, your pencil, and the latest version of Procreate, and let's get started. So you can go ahead and open up Procreate on your iPad, and we're going to hit the little plus in the right-hand corner and create a new canvas. This canvas is going to be 3,000 pixels by 3,000 pixels, and I'm going to set the DPI to 300. This just ensures that it is a large enough canvas so that the patterns come out clearly once we upload them to Spoonflower. Once you have your canvas here, you can go ahead and you can create a palette of colors that you would like to use for the project. I already have one here that is set up. I just kind of had an idea of what kind of colors I wanted to use going into this. But it's also fine to just pick colors as you go. Just do whatever works for you while using Procreate. And you can go ahead and pick a brush. I am using this kind of opaque round gouache brush that I got from Bardot Studios a while ago. I think that's where I got it from. But you can choose any brush. Any brush will work for this project. And so I'm just going to go ahead and get started. So basically, I'm just going to start creating some random marks. The pattern that I'm going to create is pretty abstract. I didn't really have an idea in mind. I had an idea of the colors I wanted to use. I kind of wanted to go with a light neutral base with pops of colors. But we'll see if I actually stick to that, because sometimes my intuition just tells me to do something different and I just go with it. So I drew a couple Christmas trees because I do want this to be like a winter holiday type pattern. I'm going to be working in a couple of different layers on this first part, just because I'm not really sure of how I want my pattern to be. I'm going to go ahead and speed it up a little bit because this part I kind of spent quite a bit of time trying to figure out what I wanted to do and where I wanted things placed. This is the part where you just have a lot of fun. You can just make marks that feels good to you, choose the colors that feel good to you, and just go for it. One thing that I am making sure that I do on this part is that I don't have any of my marks touching the edges of the canvas. So I'm kind of just focusing on the middle parts, and you'll see why in the next step we do. So I'm just adding just a little detail, some little squiggles here, a little squiggles there. This is kind of how I do with my abstract patterns. I just kind of wing it, and whatever feels right for me, wherever I see I want some different colors, I just go in and go for it. So I encourage you to do the same if you want an abstract-like pattern, or if you want to draw something specific, like you want more Christmas trees, or you want to do some presents, or some ornaments, or anything. It doesn't have to be holiday as well. You can just do random squiggly marks, or you can do any motif or object that you might have in mind. And so I'm just wrapping up this first step here, adding a little more details into my trees, and just having fun. That's the object here. So as I'm going, I also realized that I should have made a background layer. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to create a layer here and I'm going to move it to the back and then I'm going to fill it with a color. It's a really light color, so you can't really see it that well on the screen. But what this is going to do is it's going to help us see any lines or spaces that could appear in our pattern later on. And so now what I'm going to go do once I've finished drawing everything that I want in the middle of my pattern, I'm going to go in and highlight and group all of the layers that I created in one folder. So I'm going to put these in one folder here, and then you're going to duplicate that folder. I just like to do this just so I can go back easily if I need to. And I'm going to flatten one of the folders and then I'm going to duplicate that as well. And then we're going to hide the original group and one of the duplicated pieces. And so once you have your new layers here at the top, we're going to go in with the selection tool. And then you want to make sure that your snapping is turned on. So that's the little button there, and make sure the magnetic and snapping is on. And so we're going to grab our whole layer here and we're just going to slide it over to the right until it snaps into place. And then once you have that done, you're going to go in and you're going to turn on that second layer we created. And then we're gonna basically just go do the same thing. Hit the selection tool, and then we're gonna slide that over until it snaps to the other side. And now what this does is it gives us this new portion of our pattern to fill in. We're gonna join these two layers together. We're gonna click on them and merge down. So now we have one layer. And then I'm actually going to duplicate this layer as well before I start creating on it, just because I like to have backups. So I'm going to hide one of those layers, and then we're going to start working on this new layer we have here. And so what we're going to do now is just fill in this middle space here. So I'm just going to go in with some of my lighter colors. We're going to start working in the middle here just so the space isn't empty while our pattern is repeating. And so that's what I'm doing here. And just choosing some colors and doing the same thing that I was doing before. And I may add in some details to other parts of the pictures as well. So I'm going to go ahead and speed it up again while I work on this process. I'm still just working on the one layer for this part. I didn't create a bunch of layers like I did before. I just didn't see it necessary for me. But if it's easier for you to continue to work in layers, you can always merge them together again when you're ready. So I'm gonna just keep going here and just adding in some more color, adding in some more detail, just making sure it's nice and full and that it flows into the part that we created previously. So once you're finished filling everything in, we're gonna go ahead and do the same thing we did last time. But this time, I don't have any layers to merge together, but if you did, you would do that first. And then you would duplicate that new layer so that you have two of the same layers again. And then what we're gonna do, we're just gonna hide one of them for now. And then we're gonna go back to our selection tool. Make sure that snapping is on still. And then instead of left and right, we're going to move this one up until it snaps into place. I was having a little trouble here, but the snapping helps to make sure that it is centered. And then we're going to turn back on the second layer, and then we're going to go to the selection tool, And then we're going to move that layer down until it snaps into place. Yep, there we go. And then once that one is in place, we're going to go ahead and now we have a new layer to work on here. I'm going to go in and do like I did before and duplicate that layer. Well, actually, I'm going to merge the two layers first. And then I'm going to go in and duplicate that layer and turn off the old layer. I just keep these layers just as backup in case I want to go back quickly without having to undo a bunch of times. So I'm going to go in again like we did the first time in this kind of blank area that's in the middle there. I'm going to start creating on top of it. Again, I'm just creating right on that duplicate layer, just kind of bringing things in so I don't have any gaps in my repeating pattern. So I'm just bringing in a little more of this pink color here. And I kind of drift off and just kind of make sure that everything is kind of even and just playing around till I'm happy with it. So I'm pretty much done here. I'm happy with my pattern and how it's looking so far. So I'm also going to show you how to test out the pattern. So I'm going to duplicate that finished pattern layer. And then what I'm going to do is show you how to make it repeat in Procreate, just so you can test it out and make sure you're happy with it. And so I'm going to hit the selection tool, make sure that the uniform button is checked. And then I'm just going to scale it down really small, as you can see here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate that layer. And then I'm going to just repeat it over, pull it over to the left, and it'll snap into place just to make sure that it repeats. And there's like a little line there, so I'm just going to tap just to move it over so slightly. And so I'm going to do that again two more times. So I'm just going to duplicate that one and then selection tool, and I'm just going to move it up until it snaps into place. As you can see, I'm having a little trouble getting it to stay on guide, but that's okay. If for any reason, when you deselect it, you can still go back in and scoot it over. So I'm just trying to get it perfectly lined up here. Moving it up, moving it down. And then I'm going to do this one more time. Duplicate the layer, hit the selection tool, and then I'm just going to drag it over until it snaps into place. That one did pretty good, just a little adjustment so that there's no lines there. And then you can see how your pattern will look once it's repeated on a larger scale. And so I'm just going to take those and I'm going to put them in a group of its own because I kind of want to just keep them just so I can see how my pattern repeats. And I'm just going to turn that off and turn back on my original swatch. And there we go. So now we just want to go in and save our work. So go in, go to share, and I'm just going to save it as a JPEG. And I'm going to save it in my iCloud folder. That way I can access it easily from my computer or from my iPad. So just going to save to files, give it a fun name. It'll help us find it later. I'm just going to call mine Christmas pattern for now. and we have it saved. And there we go. And so now I am going to show you guys how to import this pattern into Spoonflower, and then you can print your own pattern. So you're going to go over to spoonflower.com, and then if you already have a profile, you can log in. If not, you can sign up to create your own new profile. So this is my page and my patterns that I normally have. And then I'm just going to go in and go to the design library. And once you're in the design library, you can see this is where you can go and edit all of your designs. I'm just going to add a new design here. And then we're going to go to choose file. And mine, I'm going to browse my computer for mine. And my pattern, remember, we saved it into my iCloud drive. I don't have it filtered so that it shows right up top. So we're going to go in, make sure we're in that iCloud drive. And then I'm probably going to go ahead and just search for it. So we remember we named it Christmas pattern. So I'm going to go ahead and type that in. And there she is. So we're going to pick that one. And then we're going to check the box confirming that it is our work. And then we are going to upload that. Now, once it's all uploaded, you're going to get brought to this screen here. And in this screen is where you can choose to make the pattern smaller, larger. You can choose the type of repeat. We're just going to stick with this basic repeat because that's how our pattern is set up to repeat. There's other options you have if you had a different type of pattern that you could play around with. I'm going to make mine a little smaller here. I kind of just like how it looks, and I'm going to save this layout. And then once that saves, actually, you don't really have to wait for it to save. You can go ahead and just scroll down and you can name your pattern. You can put a description in it. You can add text. If you want to sell on their marketplace, you can, make sure that it's searchable for others. And then make sure you read through all the fine print and choose your options. And you can even choose how you want it to show in the marketplace and on your page. And so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And then once you're finished, you can scroll back up. You can just purchase your, if you want to go ahead and purchase your fabric from this page, you can do that. I am going to go ahead and I'm going to make this public. And so that way it shows up on my shop. And so I'm just going to go ahead and go to my shop so you can see it here. And then I'm just going to hit new to filter it to bring it to the top. And there it is, Christmas pattern. And so I'm just going to click on it and then I'll show you what it looks like once you have it posted in the shop. You can see how it looks on fabric. And you can order it in tons of fabrics. Spoonflower has some of the best range of fabric choices. And then you can also buy it as a pillow. And you can also buy it as a blanket, sheets, everything for your home. You can put your artwork on everything, literally. And there you go. You guys did such an amazing job. I can't wait to see what you created. So go ahead and post your patterns to Instagram. Be sure to tag Spoonflower and also tag me, Sareka Unique. Thanks. See you guys later.